Amy Channel, and we continue to study partitioning schemes. And today I will discuss GPT partitioning scheme. GPT, short for GUID partition table, is arguably the most commonly used partitioning scheme nowadays. The first thing to note right away is that GPT is more unified than MBR. Historically, it is explained by the fact that when they developed GPT, requirements to the simple partitioning scheme had been already known well enough, making it possible to create a scheme which would meet current needs without requiring any adjustments. So, GPT consists of a header, the size of one sector, and the table of entries. Each describing one partition. The number of entries varies while the size of entry is usually 128 bytes, although this is not obligatory. GPT header has following useful properties. It is easy to find it because GPT header always starts with EFI path signature. And there are two copies of GPT header stored, one at the beginning of disk and the other at the end. Each copy stores its own address and the disk size as well. This allows to know sector size used at the time of partition creation and also the expected disk size, which is useful in RAID recovery. Let's summarize. From GPT header you can get sector size, the pointer to the backup copy. The pointer to the backup copy is used not only to detect sector size, but also can help in partition recovery when the main copy is corrupt, while the backup copy looks okay. Also, GPT header stores checksum of table of entries, but for all practical purposes, it is useless because somehow or other you have to use what is there. Now let's consider table of entries. Each entry describes a partition with the following. First sector, last sector, rather than the partition size. Unique identifier of partition, so-called partition GUID, but in practice it is useless. And unique identifier of file system type, which is less unique than we would like it to be. File system GUID. This set of parameters describes a partition simply and clearly. However, you should take into account that sector numbers are given in physical sectors. As for partition type obtained from the file system GUID, the same GUID can be used for multiple file systems. For example, in Windows, partitions are often labeled with Microsoft Data GUID and can contain any Windows file system. There is no authoritative list of GUIDs, and more than that, it just cannot exist. Because anyone can generate a GUID and use it for a new file system. The best list of widely used GUID values and corresponding file systems you can find in Wikipedia. To provide compatibility with partitioning software, which can work with MBR but was made before GPT, the sector stores MBR describing one partition of a certain type. This partition occupies either all the disk space or 2 terabyte and ensures that MBR partitioning tools consider the space as occupied. Now let's draw a disk with GPT partitioning scheme. First, draw the disk. There is a protective MBR in the 0 sector, which describes a partition of a certain type, EE. Then in the next sector, there is GPT header, storing the pointer to the backup GPT header. And the link to the table of entries. GPT entries. GPT backup header itself stores the link to the backup GPT entries, which is located just before the header copy. Backup entries. Now let's look at what approach is used in searching the disk for GPT. First, you need to look for GPT in the beginning of the disk. Then you need to look for GPT in the end of the disk. And after that, not to forget to look at one sector back from 2 terabyte boundary and one sector back from 128 gigabyte boundary. If you deal with old equipment, these last two points allow to consider all possible compatibility problems with old systems. On disk layout of GPT header and table of entries, you can find in our book Logical Data Recovery. In the next video, I will consider LDM partitioning scheme, which introduced dynamic disks in Windows. If you like our data recovery videos, subscribe to the Reclaim Me channel. Reclaim Me team was with you. See you soon!